Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to explain 2D arrays, also known as multidimensional arrays in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You can become a hero and save our channel by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro. Alright everybody, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to be explaining 2D arrays. A 2D array is an array of arrays. Think of a 2D array as having a number of rows and columns. That's how I think of it, at least. We're going to be assigning some cars, some car names, into each element of our 2D array. Think of it like a parking lot, and each element has a row and column, kind of like a parking spot number. So to begin, let's declare a 2D array and allocate some memory. So the data type will be string. Then for a 2D array, we need two sets of straight brackets this time. And then the name of the array, we will call this cars, equals new, the data type again, which is string, two sets of straight brackets. And then we will list the amount of rows and columns. So let's say this will be 3x3, three arrays, and each array is going to have three elements. So let's begin assigning some cars into our 2D array. Let's begin with row 0. So in order to access a certain element of our array, we type in the array name, and this time we will add two sets of straight braces. We would like to access element 0, 0. So this is row 0, column 0, equals, and let's assign a name of Camaro. Now we would like to access row 0, column 1. And let's assign a different car, maybe a Corvette. Cars at row 0, index 2, will equal maybe a Silverado. All right, we're going to move to row 1 now. Actually, I'm just going to copy what we have here, paste it. So we are now on row 1, column 0. And let's assign a different car, maybe a Mustang. And let's repeat the process. Just to speed this up, I'm going to do a little bit of copying and pasting. So we're within row 1, and then we have column 0, 1, and 2. And let's change some of these names. For row 1, column 1, I will assign a value of Ranger. And row 1, column 2, maybe F150. Okay, so we are now within row 2, column 0. So I'm going to copy that, change some of the values. Row 2, column 0, I will assign a value of Ferrari. We are now on row 2, column 1. I will assign a value of maybe Lambo for Lamborghini. And then lastly, row 2, column 2. And I will place a Tesla in this element. And there we have it. We have assigned all of the values within our 2D array. So let's display all of the elements of our 2D array using a nested for loop. So we will have a outer for loop in charge of the rows and an inner for loop in charge of the columns. So let's create a nested for loop. So this is the outer for loop. We'll need an index, int, we'll call it I for index, equals 0. And then we will continue this for loop as long as I is less than cars.length. And lastly, we will increment our counter, our index I, by 1. Within the for loop, let's add a blank print line just so that we move our cursor down to the next row within the console window when we display each row of cars that we have. Now we need an inner for loop to display each column, each element within each column of our 2D array. So we'll need an index. Let's call this int j because j comes after I. Set this equal to 0. That's the first statement. Our condition is going to look a little funky. We'll continue this inner for loop as long as j is less than cars at index I dot length. So this will take the length of our first row and we'll continue our counter, our index of j, as long as it's less than the length of our row that we're currently on. And then we will increment our index j by 1. Within the inner for loop, all we'll do is print our array of cars at element I, for this first set of straight brackets. And J, cars at row I, column J. And then maybe I'll add a space just to separate these. And what we get here is that this will display our 2D array of cars that we have. Now there is an additional way to write this 2D array. Instead of allocating all of the memory for this 2D array, what we could have done is assign all of the values right away to this 2D array when we declared it. If you prefer to write it that way, this is what will change. Instead of allocating all of the space, all of the elements that we would like for this 2D array, we're instead going to assign all of the values. So let's get rid of this portion, and we're first going to assign all of the values within row number 0. This is our first array. So within our set of curly braces, we will add our Camaro, followed by our Corvette, and lastly, our Silverado. So this is row 1. It's its own array. We will add a second array for row number 1. The first row was row number 0. So in our second array of row 1, we have our Mustang, followed by our Ranger, and lastly, our F-150. Okay, that is array number 2, also known as row 1. We are now on row 2. So let's add another array. And we have our Ferrari, followed by our Lambo, and lastly, our Tesla. All right, and then with all of this, I'm going to enclose all of these arrays within another set of curly braces. Then I'll need to add a semicolon to the end. And just so that this is easier to read, I'm going to separate each array within a new line. So it should look something like this. Eh, that's good enough. Sorry, I'm very particular about the appearance. Okay, so this is our 2D array of cars that we have, and you can see that it will work much the same even if I remove all of these lines of code. The only difference is that we're assigning all of the values to our 2D array when we declare it. Alright everybody, so that is the basics of 2D arrays. It's really just an array of arrays. Think of it as having rows and columns. If you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. Please be sure to smash that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.